Life on the road as a musician isn't as glamorous as you may think. You're away from friends and family. You wake up in a new city every day. There's very little downtime. It's a grind.
On a long and lonesome highway, east of Omaha.
But there's one common comfort that touring musicians look for to make them feel at home when they're on the road. Food. So sit back, grab a fork, a spoon, or some chopsticks, and dig in with some of the finest performers in the world. This is Road Hash. This week, the legendary Blood, Sweat, and Tears hashes out their foodie experiences over lunch at Meehan's Restaurant in Huntington, New York, before their performance at the Paramount. It's been 5 decades since drummer-producer Bobby Colomby and friends assembled the first group to successfully blend rock and jazz into a genre-crossing sound and style. So successfully, in fact, that the band's second album, Blood, Sweat, and Tears, topped the Billboard charts for many weeks and beat out the Beatles' Abbey Road for the prestigious Album of the Year Grammy Award. That album produced 3 major hit singles, Spinning Wheel.
What goes up must come down.
And When I Die.
And when I die, and when I'm gone, there'll be one child born in this world to carry on, to carry on.
And You Made Me So Very Happy.
You made me so.
Throughout the years, fans have come to love their favorite version of BS&T. Its current version, featuring vocalist Bo Bice, is no exception.
Please have the Seaside Tacos.
Of course, yeah.
And the avocado fries.
Yeah. About 4 that you recommend?
Yeah. So our burgers are delicious.
I don't know why they don't have an Alabama burger on here. They got a Texas burger. What's wrong with Alabama?
It's sort of in between. This kale salad is like pretty much
one of a kind. I almost stuck that straw up my nose. that would have been a first in the music business to accidentally stick a straw in your nose.
All right, fully massaged, Swedish massage kale thing. Okay. It's a whole thing with kale. You have to massage it. If you're a goat, you can just eat kale, but humans, you usually have to massage it first. It tastes a lot better.
Do you have any of the tacos that haven't been by the sea?
I can do a grilled chicken taco or a sliced.
Oh, that's
taco.
Just too much. That's too much trouble. I'm gonna go with a cheeseburger if that's the case.
With cheese.
Don't eat tacos by the sea. You will get sand in your teeth. This comes from experience, may
this
I add?
This is very
too.
True.
And whatever you do, do not leave the knife in the damn peanut butter, because that will not fly around this bunch. We got one guy that'll go postal on you, leave the knife in the peanut butter, man.
We have, like with food, so you have like the core ingredients before you start cooking the meal, and we have that with the four horns, the four rhythm, and bow. So it's how you put those all together, how you prepare them, and how you work them in with each other and garnish them and everything, which makes that final product what you hear when we play or what you see on like a really nice plate of foods.
So you can find clams on the menu, but you're not gonna find any clams on stage. I say this a lot about our group. It's the music is part of America's songbook. So it's you're hard pressed to not know a song of Blood, Sweat, and Tears, no matter how old you are. It sounds silly, but when you get on the road, you don't get a lot of time to eat. You don't get full meals, so
yeah.
Certain things you do when you see those places that you've performed before. And I think I might have tried one other thing on that menu at the place because I just love the pot roast when I go there.
Macros, macadamia nuts?
Oh, I thought you said mattress.
No, we call them macros. Down in New Zealand, that's what they call them, so.
No.
So it's macadamia nuts.
No.
I love macadamia nuts.
Rick solely calls
you put them
macros.
In, you
no
put them in,
calls them macros.
Like just plain Greek yogurt, macadamia nuts, and some dates or something. Amazing, really good. Ken is coffee. right? That's coffee.
That's his
sure.
favorite food.
That's his favorite food.
That's his food group.
Soft shell crabs.
Yeah.
There you go. I knew it. Bam.
I go down to South Jersey every year on my motorcycle, fill up the bags with this little shack down there, and they're like this big. Go home, sit on a spackle bucket, and clean them, and drink a beer. And
I would say fish and chips, just because of the English thing. I mean, Bo would probably answer that for me, too, even though yep.
I love the food in Germany. That was some of the great winter schnitzels and stuff like that, you know. We go there, they send us the brats that are huge, you know. I don't drink beer anymore because, well, I like having a job. But I don't partake in the beers, but you see everybody over there with a big stein of beer and a brat or a big old plate of food, and you know, just the smells and the sounds, everything about Germany is just a lot of fun. We just got back from there. I came back about 10 pounds heavier, so.
Europe in general is just, the food just tastes better to me over there. Everything just is fresh. There's no preservatives or any kind of hormones injected into it. It's just, it's food, it's real food. It's organic by nature.
We played Piombino, Italy a few years ago, and the chef showed us the fish that he was gonna cook for us that day. They just caught it. And we ate right up until showtime, went back, did the show, and then after the show, they had another course for us directly after the show. And it was awesome. And the chef was right there singing the whole time.
My favorite place, and you know what I'm about to say, where is it? What's my favorite breakfast? Where is it on the planet?
It's in Sydney, Australia.
And what do I get?
You get the baked beans on toast there.
Every
because
time.
That reminds you of your English time.
I lived in England for 5 years, man. I lived off of beans and toast, and so I love going to Sydney. See, my man knows me. See, we know each other's eating habits. I look back at every show for the past 4 years that I've been here. You know, these guys, we bring it as a group every night because we appreciate, we love one another. As you see, we break bread together. But also, it's about the music.